Hello. Today's our topic is line support. A line support is a topic in a subject power system 1. An overhead line may be used to transmit or distribute electrical power. So the successful operation of this overhead line, it depends to great extent upon the mechanical design of the line. So constructing an overhead line, it should be ensured that mechanical strength of the line is such so as to protection against the probable weather condition. So for that purpose, we have to produce our overhead line with greater mechanical and electrical strength. There are number of components in a transmission line like conductor, support, insulator, cross arm, phase plate, danger plate, lighting plates, and many others components are there. Now here is the line support. A different types of pole or tower are used to support overhead line structure, which is known as a line support, which is also called a pole. A function of line support is to support the conductor. It is capable of carrying the load due to the insulator and conductor, including the ice and wind load. The line support are various type, including wood, steel, RCC and steel tower. The main requirement of the line support is high mechanical strength to withstand the weight of conductor and wind load, light on weight without the loss of mechanical strength, cheaper in cost, low maintenance cost, longer life, and good looking, easy accessibility for painting and erection of line conductor. Now we see the different types of poles. First we see the wooden poles. A wooden pole mainly made of seasoned wood like sail or chill, and its span is very short span, like 50 to 60 meters span, and voltage up to the 22 kV. Generally, it's used only for 11 to 22 kV, mainly a distribution purpose. And wooden pole generally tends to rot below the ground level and causing foundation failure. In order to prevent this, the portion of the pole below the ground level is impregnated with preservative compound like creosote oil. There are double pole structure of A and H type are often used. To obtain higher transverse strength, there could be economy provided by the means of single poles. Now types of wooden poles. Generally wooden poles are three type structure. First one is a single pole structure, A type structure and H type structure. A single pole structure is used for low voltage and high voltage distribution line. It generally used for line voltage up to the 100 kV and use a maximum span length of about 50 meters. Steel cross arms are fitted on the pole over which the insulator is fitted. Here we see in the figure. Now we see the A type structure. And a H type structure. This A type and H type structure are mainly its name because of its like a character of alphabet A and H. The good transverse strength is obtained in this type of structure. These are employed for span length between 60 to 75 meters, and this can be used for the line voltage of 11 kV and also for some of high voltage. All these three type of wooden pole structure we have used. Now here is some objection to wooden support, or we say is some limitation to the wooden support. Now, first one is a tendency to rot below the ground level. The wooden poles are generally tends to rot below the ground level and is causing a foundation failure, which we see in the figure. Here is some wooden pole and the failure of ground level. Now, to prevent this, the portion of this pole below the ground level is impregnated with preservative compound like creosote oil. And if it's a wooden type, so there is a due to the effect of moisture and effect of weather condition, its life is very small, about to 20 to 25 years. And it cannot be used for voltage higher than 20 kV or 22 kV. Because the span length of this two poles is very low, so we not use for the for a high voltage. And it's not used for high voltage because of this structure cannot withstand an insulator and a transmission line weight above the 22 kV and less mechanical strength. Due to the wooden, we not a very heavily loaded line on it, so the mechanically it's not very stronger. It required periodical inspection. Now here we see the steel poles. A steel poles is better in mechanical strength due to wooden poles. Here we see in the figure a steel pole, a single pole steel pole. A steel pole are used for distribution line and street lighting. Generally it used in a city's area. Its life is very longer than wooden poles and has good appearance. It required reduced maintenance. There is no problem of rotting due to the treatment. There is a problem of rusting due to the moisture. So it is painted or galvanized to prevent rusting. A base plate is provided at the base to erect in the ground. And length of the pole is about 7 to 10 meters. Mopping of concrete is done around the pole for 0.4 meter length above the ground to prevent entry of water in the foundation and to provide support to the pole. This type of pole are used like up to the 33 kV, and steel pole are mainly two types, a rail pole and tabular pole. Old railway tracks all are steel pole type, and which is the I section type steel pole is used. In tubular poles, hollow round steel pipes are used and its diameter is 3 to 4 step over length. It is broad at the lower portion and narrow at the above portion. A steel pole can be used for street lighting by bending the upper portion. RCC pole. A RCC pole, which is a reinforced concrete poles. It become very popular as a line support in recent years because they have a greater mechanical strength, longer life and permit longer span than a steel pole. And they give good outlook, require little maintenance and have good insulating properties. Now see in the figure, RCC pole for single circuit. Here we see, also there is a double circuit also available, and the hole in the poles is facilitated to climbing of poles and at same time reduce the weight of line support. So there is a hole in between the pole. The main difficulty with the use of this pole is high cost of transport. Such poles are often manufactured at the site in order to avoid heavy cost of transportation. A transmission tower or a power tower, which is a tall structure, usually a steel lattice tower, used to support a overhead power line, We have seen in the figure a steel tower. In electrical power grid, they are generally used to carry high voltage transmission line. They transport bulk power from generating station to electrical substation. A wooden utility poles are used to support lower voltage sub-transmission line and distribution line. They transport power from substation to electrical customer. And they come in wide variety of shape and size. Typically height range of 15 to 55 meter. Though the tallest are the 370 meter tower of 2700 meter tower span, which is also available. In addition to steel, and other material may be also used, including concrete and wood. There are four major categories of transmission tower: a suspension type tower, terminal type tower, tension type tower, and transportation type tower. Some transmission tower combine these basic functions. Transmission tower are their overhead power lines and are often considered to be from visual pollution. Method to reduce this visual effect including underground. The steel tower may be used for a long distance transmission and higher voltage. Steel tower have greater mechanical strength, a longer life, and can withstand more strong climate condition. So here we see in the figure a single circuit tower and a double circuit tower. A single circuit tower has moderate additional cost to build a double circuit tower, and it has the advantage of continuity of supply. In case of there is a breakdown on one circuit, the continuity of supply can be maintained by other circuit.